This is pretty much the first program, okay? And as already, just imagine what we are fearful about people, mostly fearful about the lower kicks, because everybody can do them very quick, okay? And then basically the straight punches in the beginning. So you actually have already with the chain punches something very effective and with this little possibilities. What you actually is doing is not more than this, okay? So your basic side kick, your basic straight kick, and then a hindered kicks, a jabberg and a bomberg are actually hindered kicks. It's a hindered side kick, a hindered front kick, right? So it's all what you do actually, and just chin punches. And the guys do all the funny things, right? So for another 5 minutes, we do two times, and then I give you a little break. So what we do is, for 5 minutes, one person is that funny guy. Okay, just doing the chin punches, the victim first, just go like boom, boom, boom. Okay, many people think it's boring, it's not much happening, but I think it's very exciting and sexy. Because you always hit the guy, right? I think it's very good because most people like these funny movements, they look cool and you know, they're vain, but if you get punched in your face and you're growing, you're not vain if it doesn't help you, right? So that's why you want to still look cute in both faces, you better do this way, okay? Okay? So 5 minutes, just talk to your partner, who's going to be like a non-Ming-Chun person. We're going to stop the time and then we have 5 minutes switch to roles, okay? So I want you to trust Ming-Chun because look, if you do it like this, you're very rational. This means like the economy of motions, right? So you don't make big movements, exhausting movements. And can you imagine if you want like a wild guy, like in a bar fight or outside, you're going to lose lots of energy. And then you're very quickly tired. Listen, even people are very good fighters. Even they go 10, 15 rounds in like a boxing fight, in a night, like a club fight, nightclub, or any real situation, within seconds your oxygen is gone. Because why? As I explained early on, the fear level and the stress level is totally different. It already takes so much energy away and breath. Your lungs go, okay? And then you have this funny feeling like this inside and everything, all the heat comes here, you're feeling the very warm. And you already feel very weak until you start the first punch and the animal comes out, right? The finger comes out. But the problem is the part before that. Right? And most people lose lots of energy there. They're just very wild. And I want you to deal with this as well, okay? Good. Now, talk to your partner who's going to go. Get an even level partner. Get an even level partner so you can. So, look, the idea is not to kick the low kick better than the return. The idea is to help your partner so that your offensive defense movement, let's say this way, are effective against those type of attacks, okay? So let's go. We got an even level approximately. What is program two? Program two is very short. And it's more symbolic, so that you guys understand the concept a little bit again, and also the way the logic system does, and compared to let's say the GKD or WC, you see them sometimes like this. If you punch me, like punch one, two, three. So in logic system, of course, you don't do this. Or one, two, three. Okay. So we do both, of course. So what we do is when we chain punch. And from this, so the Ming-Chun first is going to give him a paksao punch to his tummy. He would go boom. See, very slowly. Boom, 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 boom. It will be at once. And you see, like a JKD, people go like this, right? Pack and punch. One, two. One, two. Even it's fast. One, two. Okay? So Ming-Chun goes one. Alright? So you know. Good. Now. So we're going to practice this a little bit. Of course, the defense if he gives me a Wing Chun, let's say, no, he gives me the JKD, 1-2. So of course, the Wing Chun would react, boom, one. Guns up, can't you see? Right? So my upper body, since, look, if he stays in front of me, of course, my center line is here, right? So as soon as he moves and pushes me to the side, so he pushed my center line here. So that's why I'm adjusting immediately my center line. As soon as it pushes me, as soon as I have this feeling, okay, look, boom. So now his center line is open, I'm in. So my upper body is rotating a little bit, okay? I'll do it again, so you do the GTD guy or whatever. Okay, now we can do it from the chain punch, but first I'm going to do this. You're doing two person, I'm like this. I'm going to go. If you want to, huh? Okay, now here, you just do this, okay? Right, and you just rotate, washed and forward. Eh? That's good, you see? That's what I want now. Elbow low, if your elbow is, see? If your elbow is high, people can always hit you here. Now that's why you have protection here and here. Cut me and punch this way, you see? Or when I'm here. Okay, you punch over here. Boom. Boom. So elbows low. If I'm here, so no control over the center. Because you can't, they can rotate your back fist. Just work on this. We make sure first our attacks like this. Okay? And the GP, the person will grab like this. So if you're doing chocolate, you will tuck the punch together. Boom! Boom! Okay? So basically, when I mean tuck the punch together, like this, okay? One, two, three, all the way. Okay, so, did you understand how our punching system deals and how the others? Okay? This is just symbolic. So they do everything together, okay? Now, since the second student program, not very advanced, of course, we don't do the bones or the tons or some of the transfers, okay? But the general understanding of it for these simple things. Okay? Now, do both ways. Of course, when I'm doing two person and you do one, two, three, that thing, okay, when you chin punch and I do this to you, you go boom, boom, that gets you stuck with a low elbow punch. See? I don't want you to start to pack the whole block, just punch him in and hit him. Alright? Good, let's go. Alright? Now, I'm going to use this on me. Can you play like now you can show off. You like a finger like this, and okay? Yes. So I'm this boring looking guy, okay? Now you go pack something with me here. Okay, so sorry, I'm gonna attack you. Mistake, I'm gonna attack you when you do what I did, okay? Now look. Boom. Oh no. What I did before. The funny guy, the show off guy. Okay. Ready? Boom, 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 no. Push me down there. One, two, three. I made your leg so smart, you see it doesn't even do it. Okay? Oh, let me take this gentleman. Let's go. That's brutal. Look at the shape of his spear. So brutal. Popeye's enemy. When you begin, you got the little belly there, the Buddha belly. Okay, now you like this. Okay, so I give you pack some punch, and then you do the boom, 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 in the back fist.
Okay.
Yes, not like this one. Not like this. Okay, the punch comes in. One, two, three. Okay, so this is what you do.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now I go boom, boom. See, my elbow is long and cut this back this I'm cutting in here, okay? And down the front, you see? Alright, let's go do this a little bit for a couple of minutes, okay? And then we start. Okay, next program is a little bit complicated. But everything is complicated, but for the complication out of the Wing Chun part. Complication is the part you do and you ask the Wing Chun people to respond. It's the easy part, but the person who's attacking, that's complicated. Okay, so to really get all this coordination in your mind, because lots of people that are in other martial arts and live by combinations, by techniques. We not, we apply our center line, our concepts to whatever he does, okay? So, I show you one of them, Daniel, can I have you? So, again, I'm one of those guys, and this is against trapping, but first we start one more, the third program is dealing with person. I'm this guy, okay? So I'm here, I just give a pack seven, and the back is. You just make a step in and give a okay? So be that guy. So I'm this person and he comes, boom, again. I suggested this, I just single it out. Instead of hitting my tummy first, he's going to pack some back fist to my temple immediately. This is the way you can stop it. Okay? But by just applying my center line, okay? Try it again. So against his back fist. Because in pictures it is scientific, again. We think not in what kind of an attack he does, we think in angles. And this way he comes to a diagonal angle. If he comes to a diagonal angle, my center line is the shortest I'm already in. You get it? So, if he deflects this hand away or pushes it away, so I have another one, he's already in. So it's a distance. See, you can be the fastest person in the world, but you cannot change distance. You can't, it's always the same. And if you have the shortest distance, if you change this, it's still a boom. It's shorter, the direct line is shorter than the diagonal. Pull back, go forward, right? So I understand the idea behind it. So we just, this is the beginning of the third program. And now you apply Kogum. Let's say I'm here, I will give him a chimpanzee, he gives me a Paxobactis, pound, pound, pound. See if I'm a chimpanzee, that's actually what's going to happen. You just stop it and you can learn it, you pack so much, boom, so you understand. But later, even from the chain punch action, chain punch all of a sudden you pack so back this. It's the same. Or pre-fight, you're like, do these things, and then here, and it comes also, you pack so back. So what? Go again, and you're chasing it, right? It comes another stick. Okay? So I chain punch him up here. Alright? So same thing, doesn't matter. So go back to your partner. One face with boom boom to the face, and you just rotate, chain punch one, cut them in, two, three, and then hand up here. Let's go. The next thing is this. So, what this, the third program deals, each program deals with topics, okay, a little bit. It is, again, when we teach you the reaction of the Wing Chun person, right, it's all about sciences again. It's not how to counter a technique with another technique. For us, in learning system, is how to apply the physics, how to apply the concept in a better way, economic way to do without losing lots of time. Look, when I say Wing Chun people learn, and the most people, as you had mentioned earlier, they go to work for 8 hours, there's 1 hour lunch break, it's 9 hours, 1 hour go and 1 hour come back home, so it's like 11 hours, you don't have much time to train every day. So this is, when we teach people, it's for the average person, which needs protection, which doesn't have much time to jump rope and do exercises and stuff. So they need some style that can immediately, from the first second until the end, for 2 hours, just deal and still stay in shape. You know, you guys are sweat and it's still fun, right? And you deal with the forces and you know how to deflect them. So in a short time, you learn to defend yourself. And this is what we care about. I don't care what style, whatever, I want to help people to protect themselves, okay? And if somebody is... this guy is very intelligent, everybody does Wing Chun here, right? So, but he doesn't eat much, he's 225, 230 pounds. He will not have that many people that approach him to try and attack him. Most of the people that attack you, they victimize you. Mostly, right? I mean, of course, there are exceptions, but the thing is, still if they accept you, can do something with Wing Chun to defend yourself, okay? If you look at all these other types, everything, if you take Taekwondo, it's a beautiful art, but it's high kicks, flexibles, it's limited of age and youth. Basically, and flexibility. So, and then some of you guys are not flexible, some of you are already too old for doing these things to be that effective, and then also, is it usable in the real fight situation, right? Then you do grappling and stuff. Again, when you grapple, still it's a little bit of age depending. You need lots of force, right? So somebody is, like him, is a lightweight, they should fight this guy in grappling, he would just sit on his face and then that's it, right? So this means all these arts are fantastic and beautiful for whatever they were designed for. But then, are they using a real fight situation for somebody who is lighter and doesn't have all the exercise like a pro wrestler, right? If somebody shoots him in a nightclub, he can change, but he can move out with the Wing Chun concept, the techniques, right? It's the, according to the concept, you need the techniques to move out. So, but he could not wrestle the guy down. Waste of energy and you open too, right? So, but it's fantastic. And all this tournament sport is beautiful. But then you always have to go back to reality. Because all this like boxing is very limited. That's why 36-year-old pro boxing stops, because it depends on your age a little bit, and then also you have not much weapons. Okay, so you don't learn how to defend against attacks, which is the jab, it's because it's a sport. You boom, you're very open. You can do these things, but if the guy kicks you groin and your hand cannot reach him, what then? You're like, oof, right? So I want you to understand things, and that's what we're trying to do here with this program. So Wing Chun is designed for the mass of the human race. So that's why it's a system that works with everybody. It's not limited on age, acrobatic, and force. This means nearly everyone is not badly disabled, like no arms, of course, no legs, and this is something else. But if otherwise you have your limbs and you're in normal health, but if you have asthma, we have little, so you can still do Wing Chun. But if you want to grapple and you need lots of stamina, so when you have asthma, you could do it. Because you're limited because of your air, right? So you need to economic look at even like grandma's friend, he had throat cancer and he was still moving very well after 70. So it's good when I have some students that are like 60, 70 years old in Germany and they move well and they can still defend themselves for their environment where they live, the people they have to deal every day. Okay, you're not dealing with some supernatural person. If the supernatural powerful person comes, you buy him 6-pack beer and say, hey man, you're my friend. That's not your environment. OK? Okay, that's why I want you to think realistic. That's what Wing Chun is about, to make you think realistic. No? I did some other arts before, it was fantastic. But the only art I really learned is Wing Chun and Eskrima. But I studied the other arts to understand so I can apply my Wing Chun, understand the physics of it. So that's why Wing Chun makes you really much more focused on self-defense. It's a total different story than all the other, what the styles are designed for, you know? And they're beautiful. Simple art, they're beautiful in what they're doing. But then I want to protect myself, and I have always trained and become that good so I can give my knowledge to help the people that need it. You know, I'm very happy he's a big boy and I come see him and I'm happy to teach him because he's smart. He's a good person, but still, you know, he's shy, he wants to, you know, he gets self-confidence. Sometimes very big people are very shy too. And then on the other hand, but mostly I care about you people. The like toothpicks, the shine, the blue, right? And people look at down at them, so I don't want to help those people because that's where I come from too. And that's why Wing Chun helped me. And today I'm strong, I can afford to be friendly, but mostly I can help these people. That's the idea. All these programs, what they're doing is not techniques. Applying the physics of nature over applying your limbs. But as long as we're built like this, it's one way of fighting. Close your fist, hit, punch, or grab a head. Okay? So we personally learn things if we don't give headbutts because we need that to think. Right, first. And second, if there's someone like this gentleman gives me a head, he probably will knock himself over his head. When you don't forget that when these things are people show you headbutts and all that, fine, fantastic. But hey, hang on a minute. Who is your opponent? If the guy who's victimized is bigger than you, want to give him a head, then maybe you just give him the wrong corner and you whoop, and you get dizzy and then you do his breakfast. So just think about these things. So that's why nature seems much more logical. Okay, so as I said, as long as you have built like this, there's only one way of fighting. So we can use just the idea, or the question is, how do we use our limbs to defend ourselves or to fight? So some people do this, some people like this, some people like this, and then two people like this. Okay? So it's about the economy of motion. How much time and what type of big funny movement I need to get there. Yeah? So which motion is more direct and less time consuming and shorter time and distance and more protective while I'm attacking? Remember, look, if you give me an easy jab, I can look like this, or I can look like while I'm attacking because I'm open. Now if you give me a jab, or I can look like this, or the other one, I can look like this, you see now? So same thing, just I'm protected while I'm attacking. In order to defend myself, of course. Okay, otherwise you need a lawyer, man, anyway. Okay, so good. So you understand a little bit again the whole ideology behind it, okay? Now, so after you have done this, now the trapping is people try to trap you, okay? Lots of these styles you're using, you know, jujutsu or jikido, whatever names, they're just names, and people try to basically lock your arms down, okay? So I only go in few things. In few movements, because later on the instructor can add lots of trappings, and you always, what I'm using is, remember the same top, Kwan Tam movement, I just Kwan Tam combined with the second and fourth punch, look. That's all what I'm going to use to defend. But okay, I'll just show you the other people what they normally do. It's like you're in the back fist, and he's punching me, and I was powerful, but he's punching me, remember the Vichu one? You're the Vichu person, okay? So I do this and he cuts in. Now I'm strong enough, but he couldn't hit me. So at that moment I can go, so I give a double back fist now, okay? 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 So what I did in slow motion, look. This is the idea. I do this, the hand comes, crack. Now my hand moves up here. If I'm behind your fist, so it's called the lap side. Now, you can see that I'm trapped in here. You see? Okay? Boom. That's what they call trapping. And then trap your arms up. Right? So, now, listen, now, if you do that to me, alright? So, back up, back fist, boom, lap, and you trap to me, see? Okay? Boom, and boom, boom, boom. I trap him. What do I do again? Boom, I hit him, and hit him again, look, very slow motion. Now, you see, back, and now, you see this hand? Hands out, grab me. Angle, boom, punch. If he's stronger before he pushes in, okay, so I guide him up to the opposite, I trap him. And then, pucks out and boom, all together, one defensive and offensive movement together. Okay, now I can do it fast. Axel, back fist. Good. Now, with power. You see? So what you do, okay? There's slow motion again. Don't hit me first, look. He's already hit. Axel, push back, boom. Now that's good, okay? Go for your target. Okay, Axel afterwards. But still, Axel, boom, 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 boom. Okay, the third one. Good, cool. So this is one. Now the same thing, please. If I try doing this, it punches. Now my hand is not behind, it's in front of us. I do not have to punch him again. No? Okay, so like this, okay, look. I do this. Two times back, so very easy, hand, look. Pop, 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 pop. Boom. Punch, turn it. With this hand. Remember now, this lower hand goes here again. Pops up, and then this shoots out again. Okay? So now I check with this one and him. Okay? Looks nice, huh? And then I forgot. Woo! So, now, very nice and easy. So, you put Paxo punch, back fist. I do this now. Yes, Paxo. Boom, right? Now watch. Boom. When he does this, he gets. When he gives a. Soon as he gives a second Paxo, watch again. Slowly. Boom. But look. You know, so when he pushes me down, my upper hand pushes down, hooks up, and then boom. Okay, that's very easy. One moment. Boom. Boom! Easy, eh? Just boom. Because look, one time here he pushed me down, and I hook in, so he pushes himself down. And what's happening is I get this beautiful little Adam's apple. Are you holding like this? Boom! Talk to your lawyer, please. Again? Boom, boom! Easy enough, right? Good. I gotta give you time to think. Learn this now, okay? So have fun. So now you have pretty much three simple back twist, lap, trapping, and back twist double power. Okay? Now we do the same thing, the same exercise, just the third one's a little bit different, the fifth one's a little bit different. Okay, now you know movement four, right? So you have this one, two back twists, three, and now we start the same thing just like this. Remember the second program? I give boom, and you punch your hands up boom. So while you're doing a guard or a punch, you see a tendency, it's back. Now does this traps it this way. So if he does this to you, Paxo punch, I go here, now you grab my head and back twist. Okay? Boom, boom. Okay, now you see, again. Boom, 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 boom. Now you do the same like the first. Laps up, very slow motion. So you see again, very slowly. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom. Now I trap him, I punch him. Remember? Okay, so let's go. I'm going on this one. How you do? The six actions. So number five, it's the same thing. Now we do like this. Okay, like I said, number five starts same. I'm here, he goes this, but now look here. Now I go underneath my partner with the back fist. The one double back fist was on top. Remember? This goes like boom. Very simple. Look. Up, 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 up. Very easy, you do it, boom, and this, now hack, and the hack, you want to get rid of this, you see, on my, there, you're already there, okay, boom, you see, okay, now here we do the same thing, boom, hooking down, you see now, hooking down, boom, okay, one more time, boom, you see, now, when this Paxo pushes you up to come, now it's 4 seconds force. In that moment, if I hook my elbow down, we push. Now you see what's happened to the big guy? It's another form of borrowing your opponent's force. Let's just use your biceps. This is what he needs to do, this to use his biceps. Now if you push up towards your face, very strong. Very strong. How 230 pounds? Mm-hmm. I'm using two fingers, push up. Now look, how can I move? I'm not leaning, I'm not pulling, look, just two fingers, no? Under my elbow. So I'm borrowing his force, his stiffness. It's making him borrow his whole body. And when you're like this, make very strong your arm, very strong, very stiff, your whole body, very stiff. Look. Right? Again, very strong. Good. Hey, strong. This guy already too smart, that's all right, make sure. Very strong. Ooh, look. That's almost tempering down. You see now? Same idea now when he does this to me. Now look. You see? One more time from here. Very, very. We have a little bit of physics to move into things again. Boom, look. And crack. One more time. And then, of course, finish you off, eh? Ready? Good. Okay. Now, the final one is things like the very big chain punch. Maybe I'm in diagonal. Boom. The guy does this to you. Okay, maybe you punch me. Maybe you're like, you can't like it. I'm like, see what he does is basically, he goes here, he wants to do this and grabs it here. Okay, just a cross, and that's it. Andrew the giant. Okay. Alright, now, you do this on me, okay? So you grab this hand, I will punch you, grab both and then like this. Okay, now, when you know this, the moment he grabs me here, look, I need to find out. You want my find out? And then go boom, boom, boom. Okay, so now, one more time. Right? Boom. So as soon as he grabs, my elbow goes low, and then I have a find out. Lapping myself and hitting. Again, find out. Find out, find out. And then lapse up punch, okay? Now, one more time, very slowly. Ooh. When he grabs me, see, grab me down this way. I say, thank you. Okay, now, this is one, the other one, if it's very strong grabs, now he grabs me this way, okay, now I chunk you have some movement like this, chunk you form, I'm just using this when I'm moving in with my elbow, lands up, this also lands up, when he grabs me here, yeah, it's so strong, pulls me, I go with him, now this hand lands up inside, and you see, lock him, and then he holds himself, and I go, thank you, I trapped him, or he trapped himself, one more time, boom, boom, no, grab me, you want to ask what you want to do first. If you don't grab me, look, trap me first, you see? Yeah. How can you give me back first if you don't trap me? That's the idea. Boom! Now, you will really trap me, okay? But if you do this and then you let me in the middle, so make sure, you do this in the middle, you let go, trap me, and let go your hands. Boom. I shoot forward, right? So that's why he needs to trap me, huh? Boom. Boom. You see? Pain. You just hold me for 1 second. Problem is that I'm explaining to you guys, and then it. Of course, the mechanism. If you go for real, go fast, move. I'm already there. Right? But it's slow so I can explain you. Pain. Now look. Boom. See? This hand moves forward. Cut into it and I'm pain. Okay? And after this, alright? So you understand a little bit? So this is pretty much the idea for third lots of program. It's trapping against it getting trapped. So climb up your secret. So look, no matter how you hold me, so if you like this, you need to let go to hit me. Boing. Okay? So now of course I'm posing again. Boing. This would be the real thing. You climb down to get out of the punch. Climb on the just together for climb down. If it's called the parallel, so if you want to hurt me, so let's say not the knee, but just the hand, you need to let go and punch. Boing. So this movement is a climb down and hit it. Okay? So you got a good idea? So you start set one, going into set two. Okay? So you have a little idea. So you still all the way up all these complicated movements with the hands, it's all clowns you can use for now. And chin punches and simple kicks, right? So this complete three. The instructor data can add other ideas, other examples. I just choose a few as you have seen it. And you can ask instructors, you can have a student come out of the prologue or you track me like you don't. You're showing, okay, very easy, okay? Good. Good luck now. I hope you guys understood till now what is 1 through 3, okay? This is for instructors very important. So okay, you can always go back in this tape and then watch with the booklet, the teaching program was exactly the thing I'm shipping out this week with another newsletter. Okay, so actually you can stop this for a second. Please not. Ah yeah. I told you so we're going to program 4 and I told you a long time ago, so bits and pieces, now I put them all together here. So the program 4 is really mostly about speed, timing in the beginning, and the Wing Chun magnetic zone, the WT magnetic zone field. So we're going to apply step by step. But I also showed you a few things. Remember when you used to do G-zone, just bone zone, Komiya was attacking, all of a sudden I won this step thing. So if you say it's like a dummy, I can kick it, punch it. And this means when I do this, if you jump back. So I'm applying the pressure, if you remember when he drops his head here, boom, my head shoots out. Remember this? So the basic concept on a bonzer or a cheetah. Now same thing, and I'm here, and all of a sudden, while I'm attacking, yeah? But okay, the poor student program doesn't have cheetah or bonzer. And then you drop, you shoot out, your whole body. So now we're going to do the same thing from here. Just chain punches, using a jump person. Doing this very simple, nervous, boom. So don't move at all. Look, I'm just doing this. I'm moving this and going to boxing position. So I'm like, it could be a kickboxer, a boxer, whatever, right? Karate guy, whatever. So as soon as you feel the pressure is off, you follow a chain punch. Boom, don't give me a chance to hit you again. Okay, so if you were a boxer, you basically leave your foot just step this circle out. I don't leave the chance in this step forward, okay? So we start with this, alright? Let's go. Also, one thing is here, look, if he's a boxer or whatever he is, just needs to attack you, and I can move. I control him and hit him here. That's the reason you always have control. So if he's here, he can kick you anytime, and you're chopping into the brain here, okay? So keep it here, you protect it now. If whatever type of attacker he is, doesn't matter really, okay? So when I hit him and he's in trouble, he covers up and he wants to go away, so he's going to step out. This is the sense I feel. So that's why your pressure up there, the contact is very important. For many reasons again. First of all, you're not open, he cannot kick you. Alright? And second is, look, lots of accidents, if you just push me, just by accident you can get hurt, alright? So this is another thing. Accident or not accident, you cannot afford to be open, okay? And there's no muscles to protect them, alright? So, and you're not always wearing your muscles with you, okay? Your groin protector, with the Wrangler jeans, that's entirely. So, then you're going to walk funny, like you're always on a rodeo. So anyway, so that's very important. So when you've done this, it's real. Control the guy jumps so you can feel, and there's another impulse you feel, okay? So, however, now, this was a short distance. Now the guy goes like a little bit further away. So if I cannot reach him, this is the step I'm reaching. This one we put the passing step in. Okay? So I see that when he jumps away, this is the short. Okay, now a lot of common mistakes. What people do is, okay, if you look at your person, they start the chain punch from all over there, like boom. Okay? So there's a big, so I don't want you like when they jump, I go from there, and right? So that's why if he's very far, let's go in. So you like it. He jumps, look, my hand is here, but now in the second step I start the punch. So I don't want you waste your energy from A to B halfway through, and when you reach your goal, then you're already exhausted. Okay? So you want to stick, if it's from here, you don't move. But from here, if I'm here or here, doesn't matter. I step now, look, my second step. So it's the same concept with one step, look. So the first step, I'm not doing anything with my hands, but my guard is up. Now look. The second I reach it, then you hit. So you don't waste your energy with the first part. Okay? Now, do the same thing. I'm here. So if he jumps back. You hit him, okay? Let's go. So bigger distance and you make the pass. Now. So it's all about understanding. So it's a metaphor. I think you call it metaphor, okay? So what I'm showing you now, okay? But you understand maybe what's happening now. You're here and you jump very far, I cannot reach you. But I'm very intentional, I'm trying to reach you. So if you're jumping and you want to go, hey, faster, look, I can reach you very easily. Okay, so, I can still reach you in the second step. Go from here to all the way to the second dummy, you see? Which one's the second dummy? Okay, go. You got it? Now, the point is, there's an old saying again, which I always liked it for the past. Since when is the bone running after the dog? So here's the dog, I'm the bone. You want trouble? If it's too far away, why should I run after and waste my energy? So if you want really trouble, come back and get it. Okay? But that's basically what it's saying, okay? So we don't go after trouble. If he's so fast, he runs away from my punches, because he's in trouble, hey, okay, so well, I cannot reach, why should I waste my energy? Anyway, then I go back from this, I go back. Okay, this is the moment we're going to apply the magnetic zone field. which I will come in a moment back to it, but you understand the metaphor a little bit here. Mm-hmm. So try again, but intentionally I really want you to catch it. So he's trying to run away. Okay? The first step. So if I can catch him, try run away. I still can't catch him. You gotta do better.
Okay.
You have to retreat faster. Okay? Sorry for the finger. Okay? But you understand basically what it means, eh? Okay? Good. It comes back. Okay, this is the moment when we apply the WT magnetic zone field theory, okay? Or concept, whatever you call it. Now, what is the longest weapon?
Psychic.
Yeah, probably the most stretched.
Really?
Okay? And of course, unarmed weapon, I mean, like your limbs. So psychic is the most longest, okay? You can reach most far. Who is the last kicker? You can kick, right? Come on.
Now, who is
it? You. Come in. You're ugly enough for the camera. Maybe discovering that. Okay, this means. Can you touch me with your sidekick? So if this would be my position, you can touch me with your sidekick. Just touch me. Now, let's turn your toes up. You see, no matter what he does, he at least needs a step there to reach me. Now, your magnetic zone field. Can I have a towel, please? Okay. Let's say one line with this towel. He needs to, can you stay on that line and pick me up on that? No. So this is the edge. Approximately there, okay. So if he's out there, outside, don't step onto that line. And don't step on this line. Can you kick me just up a further away? Step close enough or not? I see I'm very safe. I look you flexible. I see? I'm very safe here. So if he steps on the line, then I'm in trouble. There's the moment he can hit me. So as long as he jumps and does these things, I don't want to waste my energy. Okay? First. Second is now, I also don't want that the WT man becomes like a dummy, like a wax figure and stays in. Okay? So you're a little active here. First. And second is, now we will apply the opponent's own tactic back on him. Now what he's trying to do, he's trying to fake you, right? And make it trap you into some kind of movement, distract you, and what do you call this fence? Fencing?
Painting
you, okay? Painting you to make a fake on you or something like that, right? Good. Now, so when he's doing these things, no matter what he does, he needs at least to step onto that line to reach you with his longest weapon. If he wants to punch you, he needs to step further. So whatever he does, as soon as he steps in, okay, whatever, huh? I can attack it. Try again. Okay, go. Boom, boom, I'm here, go. See, I'm safe. But now you jump a second. But I'm still safe. So that's good. Okay, again. Now, whatever does, as soon as he steps into that line, this is his. See? There's no time to kick me. So whatever he does, his first step is a preparation step. Okay, he needs to step and he needs to do this close enough to hit me, with this to go in. Or he needs to step this way onto the line to do this. Whatever step he uses, he needs to be in that frame, in that zone to touch me. Now, while he's trying to do these things and he's dancing around, I'm like, ah! That's what I'm trying to do. Oh, you're attacking all of a sudden. Let him dance, and then, hey, what's it? If you dance, you always do this. Who's talking to me or the other one next? You're trying to trick me out, that's the move. You try to trick me off. Try to connect with me like you really want to. Okay? So I'm here. So, no. You are. This is a competition for acting here. Okay, you want to be drama actor, right? Character. Again, he's trying to trick me. He goes closer than that. I'm here. I go. So I go right after. Now, you can do the normal step, depends on how fast you can reach it, or you go, hey! Passing step and attack him. You can scream, you distract him, so you surprise him, okay? So while he's trying to put his plan onto you, you surprise him with his own plan. Okay? Now, if you don't play with this, And another thing is, he's not really a chucker for this exercise. He's just stepping in and prepares. And I want to see how fast you can either surprise attack him, or when he comes in, how fast you can destroy his preparation. Okay? So there are two different things going on. One, just uses tactics to surprise him before he even thinks to get there. And the second, if he's really attacking you, how fast is your response to stop him in the middle? Alright? Let's go. Your students, realistically and close as possible against the real attack. What type of attack, who cares? But you have to execute the attack at least realistically or technically realistic enough that the technique is being executed more professionally. So this program is designed to defend against people that know how to kick and punch you. Alright? The first five programs. Okay, so now, when you go for a hook, like a boxing hook, so the boxer doesn't do this to you. Mm-hmm. He's boom, crack. Now he uses upper body to rotate his hook in, so that he doesn't swing with his arm. A street fighter, he swings with his arm. Okay, and it's more like this. But the professional hook is like boom, boom. Okay, so it's not bad that you have a little knowledge. Look, I only learned two styles, the Wing Chun, Lighting System, and Lap Tosa Screamer. This is what I learned in the last 21 years. But I studied the other arts, so I can apply Wing Chun or a Screamer, okay, it depends on weapon or empty hand, whatever, I can apply against those attacks. And the more professional my partner can attack me, or my opponent, pretends to be my opponent, more my system is being challenged. More the style I'm studying is being challenged. Okay? So, therefore, we can really apply our concept, our scientific knowledge, which we've been chosen based on. You understand now? So, you don't have time to learn all this style in one lifetime. Like, so many people claim they have a black belt there, a rang there, a rang there, an orangutan there. I'm sorry. So, you are orangutan. Well, there's so many people, they always claim what how many ranks they have. I don't. The only two ranks I have is a Wing Chun and Screamer. But this I learned for over 20 years. But I study other arts. So grappling, kick, Thai boxing, karate, jiu-jitsu. So I know how they apply their techniques professionally. So the next part that you should be able to execute is jab with movement, jab and a straight, boom combination, jab and a hook, jab and uppercut, and then you try to combine them. So the most things gonna be one, the second, hook, okay, this. And then when you do kickboxing, of course you have this type of back fist, straight back fist, which we already have in the third program a lot. So now you can combine them. But first of all, what I do is I separate the attacks, hand attacks, in three angles. So since we're doing scientific, we don't think on hooks and back fists or whatever, we think on angle. Now we have a the circular attack, which is this, because this goes around your arm. I can go around you to hit you. And then we have straight attacks, straight punches, and then we have a diagonal. So back fist, I cannot go around your fist because I cannot, unless you triple, double joint it, right? And then becomes a hook anyway. Diagonal, right? A circular and straight. So this is pretty much, this is a circular. Just the upside down, and then the vertical circle and the horizontal circle. But still a circle. So this is the three angles we're dealing with. So first, you have to learn to apply this with the hand. And then, you're going to make the same with the kicks. So you have a snap kick or like a side kick, straight kicks, and you have round kicks towards your head. And the diagonals are like the X or hammer or sickle kick, whatever you call them. You remember the diagonal up? So they are the diagonal like a back fist. You see? It would be the same kick if I lift up here. Look. So like this, and then if I do this, it's the same like this. So, therefore, you can see that we shouldn't really think scientifically. It's all mathematics. Okay? Now we can apply our theory to this. Alright? So the rest is just really hard work. Now, what we're going to do is. So, now we're going to ask. First, let's do the jab. think Jeff, Jeff is giving a Jeff. Okay, that's good. So because Jeff doesn't say, lots of people who listen to me, I'm the Jeff. Okay? Now when I'm here, and I was today, he jabs me, so you see, he cannot touch me because of my hands, he needs to pass the sand. That moment, he jabs and pulls back, his Jeff is pulling me in. Very slow motion, very slowly. He moves back, and I'm like a magnet. I go in and follow his jab, so I try to avoid this one. Because I'm already in a foot, I follow the chain punches. If you do this, boom. So there's no time for number two. Because I'm on his face already, I'm in there. Boom, okay? So you get it? So this is an exercise we're going to train a little bit. So your reflexes are too late. You could not surprise me. He's boom, he's punching. And boom, I pull back, and like a magnet. So when you see it, boom, and pulls back. Boom. Even though he comes with this, see, I'm already protected. Okay? So we're going to start with this now for quick, and then I'm going to do the circular punches, okay? I see you this way, and he pulls back, and he wants to come with the combi, right? He wants to maybe fake you, open up you, and then boom, alright? So either he's in going, you move in, and boom, even he punches with this, so this saves you already from this, okay? Or if he's outdoor, see, he pulls back, I still move in. Same thing, so it really doesn't matter. And anyway, if he pushes all the way and comes here, so I can still hit him here and he moves back, I follow him. So it really doesn't matter which hand is touching, okay? You always go with him. And faster and then more you crash him, less he can do this combination. That's the whole basic idea. If you're in his face and keep chain punching him, you know, his visibility is gone and if you get hurt, you keep attacking. And they cannot do the combinations, okay? So this is the main thing if you can do that. Anyway, so now, anyone so far questions, please?
This isn't really a question, but to me it seems like we're really not, the hand movements and stuff really doesn't matter for the most part, because the one thing system is the only system that punches first four steps. So if all the other attackers, you know, a side kick or a boxing jab or hook, he's still has to step first before he jumps him. So as long as we beat him to the spot he's stepping for,
yes. So it's not a question to analyze this, huh? Good. Exactly, right. Then you don't give him the chance to attack you, okay? So whatever he needs to come after you. And that's the problem with the most other arts, that they're going and they're trying and then at that moment. Look, the two parts you're vulnerable. One is if you really attack me very fast, look. While you attack, you cannot change direction. So this means the contact, while you attack, is when you're going to be vulnerable against the counterattack. Because once you're in the air and you made your decision to execute your attack, no matter what. Now, if the guy is very good, and so we teach you to be, he punches me, hey! I see I already did it. So he has no chance because the way they attack, because they attack leaning forward. So it cannot change the directions anyway. And another one is this. When you're balanced. Right? If I push you and you're off balance because you have no sense for balance, or the Loiting Way, Wing Chun, Loiting Way, you have a total different understanding of balance than do. You know, other people think this is the balance being like here, or like being, you know, like on one leg and keep your balance like an acrobatic sense. You know, our balance is flexibility. Okay? So this is what we understand on balance. And once you're off balance, you're vulnerable. Or while you attack. So either one way or the other way, people can counterattack you. And this is what we know. And that's what we apply basically in both ways. While he's attacking me, I can counterattack him because I can change my direction. He not anymore. And if he's off balance, we crash him. That's what I do too. So if he's dancing around, I bring him off balance, you see? And I can go after him. Okay? So you apply really the both of these theories to this guy. Okay? Now, let's go to the circular. So the most difficult is people have is the swings or hugs. Okay? Now, very simple thing. So these techniques are very fast and they're powerful, of course. If you can hit you like this, lots of power because it's upper body weight and rotations behind the punch. Single punch, if you miss it, he's open. But then if somebody knows how to do it, you know, they can quickly come up with a second movement. Okay? Now you can come up with something like this, right? So you don't want to give him the chance. But however, so I have no, for the way we teach a anointing system, it's not like, oh, if it comes this way, we do this. If it comes to the other side and I start, I do this. We have to be able to do the same movement against left or right side, because you don't know and you cannot decide for him
how they attack you with that circular punch. Now, if it comes here, as you guys know, boom, 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 boom. You make the sighting step or outfalling step, whatever you call them. If you have the chance before, we have this movement right after this. So the side kick with the sliding, and you have this step. Actually, it's just this step. So this is what I'm using now. However, if you use me this way, I go pam, 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 pam. Okay, so maybe one more time from here. So if you give me the circle, so I step, basically all I'm doing is, when he goes here, I'm on the target, boom. See now, when he moves in, I'm going to circle his. Okay, so I'm not anymore there. Now at the same time, while he's doing this, this one is going to disturb him, my attack, my counter is going to stop him. Not my hand. Don't try to block it, you don't have dogs up it, or like posing with a fan, or folk cell, or whatever people do. Look, when you go, this is going to knock him off. Alright, so you attack with this hand, could be a challenger, could be a folk cell, but in action, you have no time to pose. Early on, I explained to you yesterday in the part, so when you do movements, you have no time in a real fight. If I stop the time, if the punch would come, okay, I can do this. Okay. Now I stop the film, I can do this. But then if it comes, look, if I don't stop, the film looks like this. But for that moment, I could have a tanza or pictures and whatever. But the movement is exactly the movement you have with tanza or the position. All right? But in real, it's so fast you don't have time to pose. Okay? And then what this happens is really not against this because you have no contact here. This happens if you're in contact with the guy, he pushes, now you could have a tanza. Because he causing that movement. But then if it's a free attack, this will be a block. And we don't have blocks. No, lots of WC people or other Wing Chun not liking, they will tons of block, bongs of block, we don't have it. These are movements is created by the force of your opponent. But if it's a circular punch and you have no contact, how can he create this? So this means if you get circular, my way is free, I hit him. And I just keep my center line. If you go around, look. You see? If I just rotate on my stand, just as a turn. But now, of course, I want to crash into it. If he moves in, I can crash into it. Moves, right? So I go towards him. Okay? So now. Now he can, of course, put me in a trap. He can pretend he hits from here. And I'm going the same all of a sudden, the circle punch. It becomes a boom. He does like this and it becomes the other side. What now? So should I show you another movement? And the problem is not going to work because you don't have the time to change your concept while you're already on the way. The guy faked you and you're already here. Now you go, oh, I stop. Where's my book? Okay, I have to check the number of 100 so-and-so. Okay, stop. Okay, I will do this. So you don't have the time. So this means this step has to work left or right side. Because you have no other choice. Now, since we punch, and if you know the chunk, you're the last part, you punch here, you punch underneath, and then three times on top. So if you look at the branch of a tree, like a fork, now watch, if he comes like this, I'm just showing you very easy, of course. Look, if I do this, and then look, this way, now if he pushes it, this cuts while I'm stepping, and I go behind. So I'm safe. I mean, of course, this is not the way we apply, but if you give me the hook on this side, I do this one. Boom, I fork you. Look, remember the guy with the spoon? Why the spoon? It hurts more. No, I will use it by forking. You see now, look, if it pushes in, this one pushes forward, so it cuts the direction off. I deflect this force. Basically, the same theory with these things, remember? Cutting fists, or just cutting fists. Now, if he fakes me, punches me. Okay? And since we have our head always behind, even he hits me with this side. You see? I'm always straight. I'm not leaning back, but I'm straight. Now, if you face me, comes with this. Okay? So, slow motion again. No matter, you can always do this. Look. Boom, boom. See? Let it pass through and I'm moving. And I still use the same step. The only difference is this. Okay, give me this one. Boom. Give me this one. Boom. This step. I'm always behind the person. Okay? One time outdoor. And if you hit me with the other hand, I will be indoor. But I always use the same step. Okay? So try this out. Okay? And I think I give you the next exercise also since you're in circle. Huh? Now, uppercut is a lifting punch. A lot of people hit with their arms. This is not an uppercut. Look, a good boxer or whatever, use their upper thigh, they go down and use their body weight to bring it up. So it's not this. Okay, I can hit him like this, it's still painful, but it's not that. But if I do this, I leave my arm
rigid.
This way. Yeah, this way, where go?
Rigid.
Rigid now, just I lift my up, look. Just a little bit. So my legs are bringing in, that's why it's called lifting punch. Okay, and you can practice it. Woof, woof, woof. Okay? So they're here. Okay, they bring it from the legs. So you can hit like this, but not that much power. So I want you to understand also how they execute the movement, where the power comes from, so you don't underestimate the attack. Okay? We don't want to teach you and say, oh, well, we have a solution for everything, and you can do this and that and that, and maybe if you like, you can do it this way, and then whatever. And the student asks, yeah, well, Sifu, can I do it? Of course, if you may please, so you can also do it your way. We don't want to do this. We know they are dangerous. And we know if you get this in your ribs, you're going to be down there and then snapping for air. You know if you do this, your head will be, your jaw purple, broken, or you black out, and then you don't know what's going to happen to you after that, right? So that's why it's very important that you understand that these punches, if they hit you, they're powerful. But still, we can defeat them without using force against them. So if he gives me a lifting punch here, I can don't push. Okay, that's it. Boom, that's it. My guard will be here. Or if I turn the wrong way, guns, if he does it again. Slow motion. Hit me. Or you can do this one. Oh, no, you're out of my second. You don't want to try to kiss me, try to hit me, okay? So, boom. Okay, let's move. I'm not going to pass here. So, boom. And do this. If it's the same attack, so look. I can do this way. And then you have one more thing. If you miss the guy and your punch goes and comes this way, you just cut him here. So you're stopping me, but you hit him. Okay? So you protect the team, but you can hit him still. And then continue the chain punch. Okay, no matter what he does. Okay, you give me the lifting punch. So you don't give him the chance for this, okay? Or again. Then pass. Or you stop them. Alright? So, and the same thing with the sit-ups. First we separate them so you can really solely work on the single movement, and then we're going to combine it. Later you have a really good punch in front of you, okay? And later it's going to try everything. And you try to avoid any of his attacks, okay? Good luck. No matter how fast you are. My timing is off. I consider the fastest man in the world that will always run into the wrong timing, right? To the wrong moment, right? So, however, I explained to you already, when the guy kicks me and he's too far away, he cannot touch me. So that's the same thing here. He comes to give you the hug, but his hug is too far away. So don't run into that attack. And that's why this is a very individual thing. It's, everything is visual. So if the student doesn't know Chizo, okay, you have no contact, even though he knows Chizo, you have no contact with the person to say, hey. You know, Chizo, it only makes you more flexible. Chizo is a tool, a method to make your arms flexible, your whole body flexible, right? And then also to make you flexible in the sense that you can go with the force, not against the force. So when he comes here, I can take him over, but first you need the contact. And again, if he's there, look, the whole time for the attack, boom, this is the speed he's going to come with. Now, I'm a little faster than a normal person, but still he needs to step and do this. Is already fast enough. Okay, and then the power bind. Now, this is up to you now. So you don't run in. So if he gives me, it's too far away, I will let it pass and go after his attack. And even if he misses me, he's still good balance, a good boxer, he'll come straight to the next one. So if he misses me, I go, boom, I have to be here. I'll be right there, okay? Of course, you can experiment. You don't need. But since you have to learn it, I want you, we push you into that you have to do. So he's really going for a target. So you learn to apply your step, your cover the distance, your timing, your power, your balance, okay? And then he's faking you, he pretends he comes out, whoa, you still do the same thing. Once you know how, then you can train the other way. Now you can say, okay, if he hits me and he's too far away, wait, I go after his punch. Or should go into his punch. So let him pass. Okay, of course. Alright, you have all these things, right? So the same of course is with uppercut. For uppercut he needs to be very, very close to you. And even for box, professional box hockey, it needs to be approximately almost a little bit more distance than an uppercut, but almost the same. Now, a street fight or whatever, like a bully's swing, is a very long, it's a totally boom. So the distance is longer. So this is probably untypical, it's very open, he's very unprotected himself while he's attacking, but so if this comes surprisingly, it's very, very brutal strike on you, okay? So if it just surprises you, lots of people, look, if you're in a nightclub, people are, hey, they come like this. Right, they push you and come with it from here, boom. Now, it's the same thing. So what is the push if it grabs my throat and grabs attacking? Or boom, this could be a jack. So I don't want to let him go here, yeah? But if he surprised you and you were sleepy and you didn't listen here and you didn't practice hard enough, oh, so you're going to be the guy with the head on his arm. So think about this, it's all hard work. Wing Chun works, launching system is the most sophisticated, efficient self-defense system in the world for the average person out there. Okay, so everybody can do launching system. The size doesn't matter, age doesn't matter, but the one thing it's clear is hard work. If you don't train how to do this, how to deal with these issues, yeah, of course you get hit. Right? The system is perfect, but we're humans, and humans make mistakes. Most mistakes come because they over or underestimate themselves. And the only be really good about yourself is the input you put into your training. Right? We train all our life, if you're here for self-protection, to gain that second of your life you're going to be in trouble. That second in your life, you're going to be in trouble. That second, you won't survive. But if you were lazy and you think like, oh, well, I can do this, and because you're a collector and you're like a fishing man, fishing from one seminar to another seminar, collect your movement, but you never really work on them. You never really understood. Never, there's no concept behind just movements, collecting, combination, this. Now, people teach you against one single punch. Like, one, two, whatever, hundreds of three, hundreds of movement, if we do this, we give a single punch, boom! I just do this. I do this. Attack and defend at the same time. All the time. Okay? So why should I do all the other stuff? Because you don't have the time. Because it's very fast. Okay? Good. Now, I go take this opportunity to go to the next step. Now, of course you can give me a back fist. You can do it this way. This is triangular, you know, like this. I can go right in, if he comes again, come to this hand, I do this. And he can give you a spinning back. Boom. He can like a kickboxer jump up, give you a back fist. Boom. Just shoot him down, okay? Now, try this a little bit, put him, he can spinning back fist, straight back fist, like a kickboxer jump up, back fist, whatever, okay? And then, you try to mix him. Now we just cut, he's going to like jab you first, and then give you the hook, or the back fist, okay? So you can use all this tool. And the whole idea, whatever tool he uses, I need to see. So I apply exactly what I was teaching. Remember all the stuff, we're not standing like a dummy now. I mean, you know the guy with grandma's not his bigger, I'm wrong. So don't stay like a dummy. Now if you use a good puncher, you still have this. Now see, I can already rock it. So you do this now. But if you have the wrong timing, you drop your hand because you start like this, to get there. Thank you very much. Okay? Good luck. That's it. Now you can jump back and do the kamikaze. If you give me too much time, I can wipe you right there. Okay? And you can feel like I'm too fast. I said that's the problem. I couldn't. Yeah. That doesn't mean your kicks is dangerous. So don't waste your energy. If you feel you can't reach me, go back and wait. Okay. Again. I got you, right? Careful again. Now, even if you do this, now you have to go back. So you make the mistake. You start to punch too early. So you need like three steps to teach. Then we go like from here to there. So of course, hey, the punch is not stupid. Look, if you make your opponent, if you make the guy look stupid against you trying to work, then you make yourself stupid. Try to make your attacker, your opponent, a little smarter so you have the challenge that will make your skill better. Okay, lots of other arts that teach the guy like, give me a knife like this. Ha! Ha! I'm so sorry, because no one will attack you like that. Yeah, people have another way. Boom, shoop, maybe this. You got it? So keep your opponent smart, so which makes you smart. Keep your opponent stupid, makes you stupid. Because you make your, there's no challenge. Or give me just like a swing like this. Hey, boom, 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 boom. Fine. But you go out there, things look different. So that's why now when you jump back, careful with when you chase him. The danger is right there. Because this is what they do, this is what they do in brain. This is what they learn. If you chase him, you chase him, you go, hey, hey. They know these things. So, so that's why the timing has to be right. And you have to really be able to crush him. If you cannot reach him, just go back and take him up. Play the ball, let him be the dog. Remember? Okay, try it again. When you jump back from the chain punches, you crush him immediately, or if you cannot reach, you go back, and then now I'm trying to get you. Now I can use all my hand techniques. Jabs, hooks, uppercuts, okay? Combine and try to, maybe I do this. Now look, I'm in your zone, you hit me. Maybe I jump back and then you watch. Okay, so have fun. One more time. But punch, second punch a little bit more. Okay, let's go. Very quick. The kicks. Okay? So the boxer's now become a kick Thai boxer or whatever, right? So once you went through all the four programs, you mix the first all the way up to fourth. So the guy can trap you, the guy give you low kicks, all the simple basic first program stuff, and of course his combinations, okay? So you try to prevent them from doing that. Okay, now, same as I mentioned earlier, the kicks we split in three parts, and I give you three ways to solve it, okay? The best way is the first one, you just is a step. If you can step fast enough and crush him before he can use his attack on you, his kicks, or even his punches later, okay? So, now, look, again, it's all about the right distance now. He jumped back from the chain punch, he's up there now. But before I go back to, so let's say, we differentiate again in circular, diagonal, and straight kicks. So the straight kicks basically could be a side kick. So if he gives me a side kick, or I don't know, then maybe you jump in and give me a side kick like a karate guy. If I got just with my step, I can do the same thing in the side kick. I'm here. There's your kick. See, I just can't let him pass and hit him, all right? So this is the first choice, again. Okay. So I can just crush him from the side, see? All what I do is this is good. Okay, so just stay there. Just stay there. Okay, very simple, huh? Now, if I'm a little bit late, he kicks me, I can use my head. Wait till the guns, huh? If you kick them, just let me try. And they have champ for you, remember this movement?
It's not a box.
It's a go. No? it's an indoor bongzo. So see, look. Also is something a little different. Looks more like this, okay? So, and you can't do this, no look. Movement. Okay? The last part is, you can always use. Kick his. Somebody turns his hand to you, you kick his hand. It's bacon, all right? Now, so this is against, or it could be, of course, a snap kick up above your belt. You know, like sometimes I take one to kick under your chin. So if he kicks me up here, okay, again, I can boom, I can do stop kick. Remember first program? But now if he kicks higher, you see, he's not down there, he can kick you up all the way up here to your solar plexus, whatever, right? Now, again, he does, my step. First choice is the best choice, or, boom. Remember see on top? Lanza? No? Lanza, sorry.
Lanza,
alright. Okay? So in or out, the kick again. And punch, okay? I can go in and do this. And the last choice, always again, it kicks me. You kick him, boom. Kick him, move in, okay? Now, this is again straight. If he gives me a diagonal kick, could be like your X kick. If I get on the box, this is what they try to do, go over here to your temple or your collarbone, kick here, okay? So since we stay like this, if it does go, just move in. You cannot pass this, but if I do this, you can pass. Give me. I'm in, right? So, what you do this, is of course again, look, just crush it. So second, you take it, if you go on top, move in, okay? So this is your hand movement. So if you're a little too late. But if you're way too late, the kick is always because you're lazy on your foot, people, if you cannot step. That's why you're doing the kick. But I was too late to start. Did you get the kick? Kick is it. He's even afraid. You just kick his joint, that's it. Alright? So the last one is circular. So circular could be a spinning roundhouse kick, spinning back, that's it. So same thing. If you do this, you can hit. Move into the hand technique. But again, the first choice is this. Step in, right? You crush it. And the last one is. As I said, if it turns his ass, you kick his ass. Alright, very simple, right? But this is because, again, this kick is because you're too late. And after you kick, you still have to go in and don't let him recover. Maybe you did not have hurt him and he's ready and recovers in less than a second. And he's ready to attack you again. You don't want to give that chance to your opponent. Okay? Now, or you can give a round toss. Again, I'm here. He does a round, I just crush him. Okay? Or if I'm too late, then of course, you can do this and throw him away, I don't hurt him. Or he comes, kick him, move in, chin punch him, okay? So these are pretty much the kicks. I'd like you to work with this now, separate them single, okay? And then when you throw everything, you feel a little confident, then you can mix up the entire four programs. And then we go into program five, which is distance three, knee and elbows, okay? Different kicks. Spinning back kick and the upper back. Does everything. He's the king of the round toss, low kicks, the straight kicks. First program, he's trapping hands. He can try whatever he wants to drive. So once you've been through all this stuff, and you really exercise step by step each, you have an understanding, you can apply it. Now when we do it free, he's trying and you don't want to get hold, you don't want to get kicked. You're trying to prevent everything right on the beginning of the root, before the plant can grow, you chop it off, okay? So, you know that there's the ivy, right, the bad plant? So you try to chop it off before it's messing up the garden. Okay, so when we do it, he does anything else. Do whatever you react. So it looks not so nice, but the fight is not nice. But now, see, whatever he does, I crush him all the time. Okay? So from the cheek, he tries to go boom, boom, boom. Don't give him a chance for it, okay? So I'm going to go to program five. Some of you people are not ready for that. Going one and two student levels. Okay, I think it's quite a lot. Who is only doing first and second today? It's very difficult, eh? I actually like you to practice with Fatma a little bit. Okay, you listen to this, but I don't want you guys to do this now. Alright, because it's too much, okay? So I'm happy if you repeat, review the whole thing, okay? So, now. Okay, I just show you what we're going to do. Of course, it's going to start to go from the chain punches later on, okay? Just give your shoulder to shoulder, like hold like this. Now, we're not going to push around. So if he gives me that circular knee here, I'm going to give him a Charlie horse inside and go wham. If he gives me a circle of the same knee over here, the same knee, I'll see him like this into my ribs. Ouch, you see? Do that this, go boom, boom. Okay, so you Charlie horse, it's almost like a bomb and jump rope, but you attack his leg and then go to his torso for now. Later, if he bends down, of course, in class, but please don't go to the face so we don't have accidents. So, I'm using the same leg. Look, if he comes this way, pam, pam. If he comes the other way, pam, pam. Okay? So, if he comes with the same, with the other leg over here, pam, pam. And then diagonal. So, you have both sides, four sides, you see? Diagonal and parallel. Simple as that, okay? Now, if he comes with a straight knee like this, so, that's all you want to do, okay?
No.
Same thing. That's okay. Just come from an angle, okay? Give him a knee. Okay? So you basically attack him and then give him
to start with this. Let's go.
Understand us well. We're not teaching you guys techniques and combinations. We're teaching you the concepts, how to apply the dimension concept. Okay? So, if you look, it's not really combination. Once we taught you how to defend a certain attacks, we're mixing it up, so you don't know what's going to happen. What we teach you is to understand the concepts. Once you understand, you can always use your limbs to attack anytime, to defend yourself anytime. So you're not relying on, oh, he's doing this punch, now I can only block it like this, and block it like this, or deflect it like this, or you don't care anymore about it. You know what to do. You just go and hit the guy. But you have to deal with the main issues. And this is balance, power, all the stuff you're doing with your punches. If you have no power behind your punch, how can you knock the guy out to defend yourself? You cannot hurt the guy back. Take him out. He will always keep attacking you. So you need powerful punches, you need aggressiveness, and this all has to also the balance. If you punch and then you go like all over the place, how can you hurt? How can you fight the other, right? But this all has to do with the concept, principles we're using our limbs according to defend, right? So we're not teaching you like, oh, he gives me a punch number B and I have to do block number C. So this would be like everybody else, so we don't do that. And this is why we Chung here and Matosa Screamer are unique. They're totally different, separate, long-standing arts, a very effective each of them. One in veterinary, one here, empty hand. But again, but we have the same ideas, concepts. We work with concepts, not with techniques. Let the other people be defenders, then do techniques. Okay? So very, very important that you understand. That's what we're teaching people. But once they go into the trap, say, oh, it's combination. Listen. If you train us combination, what's going to happen? The person out there is not going to do that combination. But if you train and teach yourself and your students free-minded, so thinks everything is open, so then you don't have combination because it's not going to happen. So this means now you have to apply something always works. These are concepts. This is what we're doing. Right? So you don't like, oh, we give me number elbow, so now I have to do this. We show you how to move your limbs, we show you how to do it, but then you can do it all the time, no matter what the guy does. So you're not relying on the attack. You understand what I'm saying? You don't rely on his attack anymore, you just go, oh, boom. No matter what comes between, you can deal with it, okay? Good. Now, Daniel, come over. I know, last 3 days I watched The Planet of the Apes. I'm serious, I did. I bought the whole series. Taylor. Okay, now, this is just the way we exercise. Of course, later, from the chain punches, and also you as the instructor can always go back and teach the same exercise classic. Let's say, because Mirautos, the moment for student level, boom, things like this. I mean, just goes very close to the Charlie horse. Boom, 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 you can do this. And now we can do this with a different person. I feel like this, maybe I go and grab you and go, boom, the knee in, right? Maybe I'm here, we got you with the knee, boom, boom, this kind of things. Okay, you can also switch. Somebody on the trip, he grabs my hands. Maybe I'm here, then suppose you give me the knee, whoop, he wants to do this maybe, okay? Go like, boom, I hit you here, maybe now I can use this one. Boom, okay, why not? You can do all this cross knees too, okay? Or he does me again. Boom! Boom! Hey, you hurt my elbow. So, okay, you can do these things too, but now let's start with certain things. So, if I'm using Chung, then the guy's like this, and either he's very tall, like Michael Jordan, or maybe somebody does this, jumps up, huh? Goes up and gives you an elbow from top, or maybe he wants to do this and jumps up. If you do this, look, if I'm here, you jump up and give me an elbow. Yeah, something like this, why not? Okay? At least hold this side or something like this. Now look. You step in, remember? Chunk you? So here I apply lots of chunk you stuff, okay? Very slowly, or you come and give me an elbow to my temple. Boom! Because I go in strips. With the guts, I go. Boom! Boom! Okay? So you can also exercise just like this. Single or together, okay? So when he comes in the elbow, I'm here, okay? Okay? Very slow motion. Let this pass go quick, okay? You start with this first? Alright, let's go and I'll show you a couple more. That's why I have to use this part here. Now, don't get that comfy. Okay, now, so when he gives me, let's say we're very close here, boom, he grabbed me, shut up, he did things, okay, and all of a sudden he goes, oh, okay? So, we here, maybe that close thing after chain punch, let me do this. Chain punch, boom, boom, guy okay, like this, huh? Maybe he wants to crack, something like that, whatever, okay? So we're here, so if he comes with an elbow in the middle, and up here, you see? So when this happens, look, boom, let him pass, just push back, do the same thing again. Okay, so you deal with the circular, just let him pass, okay? If you're here already, you use your, go, so you let him pass with the plateau, help him to go over there, and you can give him this type of things, okay? Very simple, huh? Or you can do this one, alright? So I give you this choice, and then also, otherwise maybe I'm here and he comes with a circular elbow, and I'm already here. So in my practice, I go, doing the round elbow, just like this. Okay? Very simple, right? That's chunkier. I'm here, he gives me a circular, just rotate it in, of course, you're chasing it. Each time you can do this, one mostly chunkier. Right? So this is the movement and chunk, you remember this movement? Just combine with this, and then boom, 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 boom. Alright? So, very simple, you have this kind of elbow, you have the circular elbow, and you can also give it like a back fist type of elbow. This kind of elbow, okay? And if I'm grabbing the other, boom, I can do this, huh? From here, and I grab, boom, boom. This end, you can go right and say, boom, and crack, okay? So, another choice here. And really just take a lot of this. Your hands are here, you can stop them and give them. As soon as you have no contact, it's of course difficult, right? So, and whatever it does, look, his elbow's only that long. He needs to be close to you. I always try to keep him away, but sometimes people grab your wrist and then all of a sudden you go woof. Okay? Now, I also want in this, or whatever the guy grabs, all of a sudden, this is like karate elbow, very traditional. This kind of elbow, right? Just deal with it. Maybe sometimes I'm here, the guy goes, this time of people do this one, you think, right? So when I'm here, they give me a karate and the elbow, boom, you see? Boom, boom, okay? With this. Very simple as that, okay? And what I do is he rotates.
An elbow.
Yeah, and then give me like this, right? This kind of elbow, like the movie actors, like action. You know this? You just see it. He's giving this elbow in his back, okay? Let's go. Try out a little bit of everything. Well, this is pretty much all fit program, okay? Now I want you to mix knee, elbow together, alright? So, elbow against this, elbow against this, elbow against this, elbow against whatever, right? Boom, elbow against height. Like, very simple, whatever elbow karate uses, need to go, hey, this type of thing, right? Or like, time offsets, boom, this type of thing, boom, they come, boom, okay? Palm, palm, these things are using, and basically, this is what you're defending against. Very simple. So if he gives me a, you can stand and teach it, if he gives me an elbow up here, let it pass, bring him down, boom, if he gives me an elbow from the side, I go like, boom, crush him, boom, like you can have your hand here, okay? But if he gives me an elbow, really like this, maybe I can stop him here, give him the boom, boom, okay? Or chunky, everything comes from chunky here. Simple as that, okay? If he gives me a spinning back elbow, he just going quack. But as long as I also, even if my elbows are turned, I'm going to pop my center line. Boom. If he gives me the elbow here, so I can go, okay? Painful too, right? It's kind of the stuntman. But if he gives me this kind of elbow, no, this one. Yeah, you see, there's a lot of people do this. So if you give me that thing, look, I can, boom, this can't work. You can't look, I just, he's smaller than he went. Just give him a front elbow. Pull him down and give him, okay? Paxo, a lot of things I use in that moment. My paxo and then, or like, boom, crack him and then go, crack. Boom, boom. Alright? Simple as that. Okay? So, again, you are doing your counter elbow against. Boom. 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 Boom or boom. Okay? So that's it. So these are the things people use. So we don't want to Wing Chun against Wing Chun, like Wing Chun typical. Okay, this Blue Chi form is higher level, it's not the student program anyway, and this is what you're going to be confronted with. Guy goes, hey, what? Maybe that's just to you, right? Hey, what's wrong? Boom, this is what's going to happen outside. Oh, sorry, crack. Oh, really? So these are things people don't use. Somebody knows a little bit karate, Thai boxing, type of attack, okay? Have fun, hurt each other.
I show you how the other guy can attack you, what type of elbows, right? Now I want you also to be able to use your elbows too. Now you can, if he doesn't move, just careful, of course. You just go in the guy, go crack. They go, bam, crack. You can do the same thing. So just imagine he gives me the elbow. Very slow motion, look. You give me this elbow, I can't stop in this way. And just give me the elbow. Right, go crack, crack. Okay, go up this way basically. Boom, boom, back down. Okay, oh, he gives me the elbow circular. And I go, boom, crack, crack. Okay, crack. Boom, boom. So you can use this elbow, you can use this elbow, you can use this elbow. So just be flexible with it, okay? Now once he gives me one attack. Boom, crack. Of course, don't need you one hand. Okay? Or give me a this elbow. Crack. Okay? Talk to your lawyer, right? So very dangerous stuff. So when you do this, and then we go back, everything goes. But please, careful. Dangerous stuff, you probably just need to move a little bit too much in and then you have an accident, okay? So I want you to do chin punches after you're done with the elbows and mix, everything goes. Now, one very important thing I want you to know. If you have seen my video, the Wing Chun Sunset, I'm talking about the five distances. And this is basically a little bit more individual for each program, each distance I'm dealing in this one, right? So now, I want you to understand that a real fight does not go distance one, distance two, distance are jumping. Then maybe you start trouble here, what's wrong with you, right? So it starts mostly out of the second distance, which is hand punch distance. Hey, what's wrong with you? Huh? So now the guy can push you, and then open for his first distance, out of the second, or the guy goes like, hey! Now you're running from the second and the fifth distance on the floor. Okay, so you cannot choose really where this is going to start, the way it's going to start. So this program should bring you, because you deal separately with age, should bring you, and this is what I want you to understand, even though individually in each program you deal a little bit of distance, but then also brings you to the understanding that distance can jump, because just the way a situation occurs or happens. So you never know, you're not in charge where the fight's going to start. Guy's going to come and yell you from here, or it's going to be a very peaceful, oh really, hey, try to trick you and go into the third distance. Okay? So whatever the situation is, because I cannot go in and talk for every situation. You don't know when trouble's going to come at you. And you have to be aware of it. But then, that's why once you understand about distance, and once you understand about being cautious about people, attitude and things like this, so you can go, hey, that's the moment you can prevent certain things. That's the moment you can keep a distance for you. If you say, hey, the guy's trouble, say, okay, come on, I better stay here. Or if he comes very close, we didn't talk to you, and you have a very bad vibe. You know, I'm on the bar, sitting here with my Coca-Cola and milk. I cannot say alcohol, right? You know what I mean? So he's here, and he can drink too, but I feel he's a little troublemaker. I could see him before, so I'm just cautious. But maybe he talks to me and says, and he goes like, hey, blah, 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 blah. And I said, well, okay, whatever. I could be even friendly all of a sudden, boom. Because it's just a mean guy. Just a drunk or whatever, all of a sudden he wants to stick his elbow into your face. So you never know when the distance is going to happen. Everything's different, so I can always talk just in a general sense. You understand? So there's nothing like, oh, this is the way 100% going to happen. And in that case, I would make myself stupid and then you guys stupid. And we are not. We are very intelligent and we know what we're doing here. So that's why this is all individual. And this program should make you aware of the danger of those type of attacks and should prepare you. Or instinctively too, not just physical. You know, everything you do here is all up here.
So when even there's nobody threatening you, but you can feel trouble, you can feel bad vibe on people, and you can already psychologically and inside already get the distance before even the guy even talk to you. Maybe he's never gonna talk to you, but you don't know. Maybe he's gonna pass you to get to somebody. You don't know what's gonna happen on the way. Maybe he's just causing trouble moving, right? So you don't know. So, but if you have a funny vibe already, you did one of apply the concept. You already go like mentally, you already go like this, doesn't pass. Because he's an idiot, he's a troublemaker. So it starts already there. Okay? Look, we trade all our life for this. But most of the people don't fight physical. Most people are relatively nice people. Quite polite, friendly, but then you have some people out of hand that walking around very funny. And this is what I'm saying. So you can prevent the physical fight already by selecting off, because the vibe is coming at you. Say, oh, this guy's traveling already mentally. I already make a mental bones out. I already let him pass. Okay? Or a mental deflecting. Because I know if I'm going to stay here, this guy's going to come and touch me somehow. And then I have to say, hey, look, watch out. And then he's going to maybe start traveling. So why should I? You know, lots of these things you see already up front that this is a problem zone here. And then why are you going to go and push it? Right? Only stupid people stay here, and I know this guy's trouble, so I go wait for him to wait past me because I'd like to fight. But hey, it's not what we're teaching you. Remember, it's self-protection. We don't teach you killer instincts or street fighting. Okay? Like lots of people teach you in the tapes and stuff. I don't teach you this. I teach you to survive. I don't teach you to be a killer. I don't teach you to be a street fighter. You know what street fighter means? The word you go out and find.